Sensei got a feet out. I'm out in the party. I'm on my big full shit. Ready to get it started. Bitch, I got no sense. Go hit a plug. Ride around with folk. Call me Kobe 24. Can't fuck with her no more. Dollar bitch, she do the most. I get my groove on every time.
What is up, YouTube? Alright, so look. Hey, I just had to try it. Don't make fun of me, bro. Don't make fun of me. So look, man, we are back with another video. It is your boy Carlin, So Ordinary, man. And you know what's the deal? Every single video, we started off by doing this. Like, comment, subscribe. No, scratch that. We got some new. Like, subscribe, and turn on them post notifications. That's something that I like better, because I want y'all to see every single time I upload a brand new YouTube video. Because it's always pressure, man. So look, we back with another story time. And this one is an interesting story time. This one we can relate to, because I think every black kid could relate to this story time, bro. And you seen the title, it's about the worst. I'm not gonna curse, it's about the worst butt whooping that I ever received in my entire life. This story brings back nightmares, man. It brings back nightmares. So let's get into it right now. But before I do that, hold on. I gotta take a sip of my water, because I be talking a lot and my throat be dry. Alright, so growing up, I wasn't really a bad kid. Okay. I was a troublemaker, but I wasn't bad, you know? I made mistakes, I did things. You know, I did a lot of things that got me into trouble, but that doesn't mean I was a bad kid. I had a heart of gold, you know? It was just tainted with a little bit of green, like a little bit of rust and stuff. So I had to, you know what I mean? My mama had to whoop, you know, the rust off of it. She had to clean it off. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Most of us deal with it. Most of us experience it. Most of us who grew up in a black household, or if your parents just didn't play. It didn't have to be a black household. It could have been foreign people. And my experience was, every time I would get into trouble, I would get a behind whooping. I would get my butt torn up. I'm talking about, y'all ever see them memes where people want to wear multiple underwears because they know what's about to go on? It was like that bad. Like, it was that bad. And to this day, I appreciate my mama for whooping me, because my father wasn't in my life, so I didn't have anybody to really discipline me on the level she did. Now, I'm not saying she took up from my father, but she did at the same time. You know, my mama came in clutch with the whoopings. She couldn't show me how to be a man, because a woman can't do that. However, she tried her best. She showed me what most men, how a good man, or what we consider a good man, is supposed to be, and she whooped that into me.
We can spend more time together. I love you, mama.
So the story happened. I remember exactly what happened, because I can never forget this moment. This was a life-changing moment. So this had to be the summer of my third grade year. Summer of my third grade year. And y'all like, dang, you getting in trouble in the summer. And yeah, I was getting in trouble in the summer, because you shouldn't even be getting whoopings in the summer, first of all. Like, at all. You shouldn't even be getting whoopings in the summer. Summer should just be fun. I made it through the school year. I did the stupid schoolwork that I had to do. And you trying to whoop me? Whatever. So, I remember third grade year going into fourth grade. And I went to this summer camp called Boys and Girls. People from, I think this is all around the world. Not all around America. Boys and Girls. And I don't know what exactly I did that got me into trouble, but what I do remember was, I think I was arguing with a boy back and forth about something. We got in trouble for that. They made me go sit in timeout. Now, here's the crazy part. I honestly didn't believe that what I did deserves why I got whooped that bad, but parents, whatever. So I got in trouble. I did something with them, got in trouble, had to go sit in the timeout, right? I get in trouble again. I think I got in trouble three times that day. So that's when they made me leave early. They called the person who was dating my mom at the time, my brother and sister's father. RIP, he passed away from COVID. Dearly loved, because he did make some type of impact in my life. I can't lie and say he didn't do anything. He did, you know. He took up for my father not being there a little bit. And I appreciate him for that. So, like I'm saying, I remember they called my people. He came and gave me. Now, I was in trouble because I knew what it was, man. I just knew what it was. You niggas in trouble. And I'm like, I don't think I should get a whooping, man, because I'm a good kid. Like I said, I'm a good kid. I don't believe that I should be getting a whooping. But it was whatever. So he gets in the car and he's like, what's your problem? And I'm like, I couldn't even talk because I just knew like what I had coming when I went home. And I was just like, I don't know. So he takes a brush, and this is technically child abuse. So he takes a brush and he smacks me on the head with it a couple of times. And I start busting out crying. I'm like, ah, ah, ah.
Oh my God.
Being dramatic. So we get home and they're like, go take a shower. And I'm like, go take a shower? Why? Why do I need to take a shower? And they're like, just go take a shower. Me being in the third grade, girls, guys, we all know that when we were younger, we did not like to take baths.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
That was a fucking lie.
I don't care what nobody says now, but I know for sure when I was 9 years old, 8 years old, I ain't washed my stink butt. I just didn't, you know? That was just me. I didn't wash myself because I felt like I just didn't want to do it. I just didn't. And being 18 now, and I'm like, damn, that is like nasty that I didn't want to wash myself. My little brother, I'll be getting on my little brother because he don't do the thing. He don't walk. He don't be one to wash himself. I'm like, bro, that's dirty, bro. Wash yourself, please, because you're getting at the age so where you starting to be musty, and nobody want to smell that. So I'm like, man, I don't want to wash myself, dude. I just want to go lay down. So, but whatever, I go get my clothes, I get ready, I get in the shower, man. So I'm in the shower, and, you know, I'm just in the shower, no music, because I was too young to listen to music and me in the shower at the same time or whatever. So I'm chilling, just in the shower, doing me. And what's crazy is I had a strange feeling. Like, it was a weird feeling, like, to stay in the shower as long as possible. And that's what I did. I stayed in there for like 30 minutes. Now the water was only cold for about 20. And I was just in a cold shower. I was literally taking a cold shower for 10 minutes because I knew something wasn't right. Something like I don't need to come out that shower early. So I get out the shower, turn off the water, and I'm like, man, what did I do today?
Wow.
Just thinking about my life, because I'm like, what did I do today? And I hate thinking about this, bro. And I'm butt naked, right? I'm talking about little 8-year-old me, butt naked. Nine, I'm pretty sure I was nine. Yeah, nine. Little 9-year-old me, butt naked. And they buzzed the door open. I'm talking about building a head, like, and I'm just looking like, just backing up, and they like, yeah, you wanna cut up? You wanna cut up? Bow, bow, bow. And
what's wrong with you? What's wrong with you?
I'm like, you know what it is, like, you know. You know how it is to be getting whooped. I don't know if y'all ever got whooped butt naked coming out the shower before, man. But it was traumatizing. Because they didn't just do it for a couple of... Man, they did it for like 5 minutes, man. 5 minutes. You've been butt naked for 5 minutes. Like, you don't understand how traumatizing that is to a young boy. Because you know, you're not supposed to be getting whooped butt naked. I'm not a slave. I don't work on no field for nobody. You don't whoop me like that. Man, like, that was crazy. Because I frankly remember after getting whooped for them 5 minutes, I stayed in the shower for an hour. I stayed in the bathroom. I put on some underwear, put on my shirt, and just sat on the toilet for an hour. Just sat there. Because you just don't do that, man. You just don't do that to a person, you know? You just don't do that to a person, man. You know what that does to a young boy? That messes him up in the head. But yeah, that happened. If y'all could really relate, I know a lot of y'all can, because most of my viewers come from black households. I know y'all mamas and daddies don't play that, bro. So this is why I had to make this story, because I knew a lot of y'all was gonna relate. I like to make stuff that y'all can relate to, because it's funny. Because it's now that we're older. Hopefully, you're not at the age to where you're still watching this and those things still happen to you. You know, if you're watching this at 8 and 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Ooh, you got... Ooh, especially if you 8. Ooh. Just don't get in trouble. That's all I can say is just don't get in trouble. Yeah, that's the best advice that I could give you. Just don't get in trouble. But like I said, I like giving y'all stuff that y'all can relate to. I heard that, like I said, there's going to be another lockdown. I promise y'all would drop a video 5 days a week. Maybe seven. Maybe seven, you know? Because I ain't going to be doing nothing. If there's a lockdown, I will, man, look. I'm going to be the best version of me. I promise. We at 150 right now? By the time them 60 days over? Man, we coming out that mug with 1K. 500. At least 500 subscribers. And that's all. So, if you liked the video, leave a motherfreaking like. And if you're a new viewer, subscribe. If you made it all the way to the end, I really love you. I'll give you a kiss right now. Only if you're a girl, though. I don't give dudes kisses. But, you know, peace. Had to show them they were wrong. Forget your opinion.